just a quick book placement, product placement for my books under the author name Derek Hemenway. First, we have the first installment in The Human Saga, which is my epic trilogy of novellas about a future civilization of corporate fascism that is being invaded by an alien cult. We have The Mortician's Daughter, a dark fantasy set in Mesoamerica about a sorceress who blocks out the sun to create a kingdom of darkness and evil, full of ghosts and monsters. It's fucking awesome. Part 2 of The Human Saga, and then Part 3. There's currently my first full-length novel in the works, so be on the lookout for that. That's about all. Song Snob Reacts! Hallo, mein Name ist Nathan Songsnob und ich liebe Rammstein. Yes, I've been waiting for this. Right, since I'm diversifying my content, I'm going to do some industrial. I'm going to do some Rammstein. And yes, I can in fact speak a bit of German. I'm currently learning German through Duolingo. I'm a big Germanophile. I love German stuff. And I've been trying to learn the language for years, and I've discovered Duolingo on my phone. And I like to promote that app as much as possible. I think there's a website version now. But yeah, we're going to do some Rammstein. I've always loved their music. And I understand that they're kind of a controversial band, because sometimes they do cover some topics and imagery that are fucking gross. And I have been more active lately, partly because I'm just loving my new YouTube mic. It's not the best YouTube mic ever, but it's better than what I've had. It is so much better than my crappy old webcam or microphone. And I messed with some settings on my recording software so everything looks better. I'm sure you've noticed the increase in quality. I'm going to try to stick as close to quality as I possibly can. But keep... something wrong with my throat. But keep in mind, I'm a very DIY kind of person. Very do-it-yourself. I like to keep my means simple, straightforward. Anybody can do it. Because that's what I loved about YouTube back in the day. Is I loved this DIY approach to everything. And I want to maintain that energy. I love that DIY approach. So I don't necessarily want my production to get, like, seriously huge. That's just kind of my philosophy of YouTube. You can take that or leave that. That's how I like to do things. So with that being said, Ich will spielen Rammstein. Sehr gut. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and go.
Ich kann auf Glück verzichten. Das Unglück in sich trägt, muss ich es vernichten, was ich liebe, will ich richten, dass ich froh bin, darf nicht sein. Ich was liebe, ich mag es nicht, wenn ich was mag, ich freu mich nicht, wenn ich mich freue, weiß ich doch, ich werde es bereuen, dass ich froh bin, darf nicht sein, wer mich liebt, geht dabei ein. We'll be right back.
This is one of their more ballady songs. I kind of like those. Ohne Dich. To translate the title of this one, in case you were wondering, is What I Love. Well, knowing Rammstein, this is probably going to get not... This is not going to be a love song. This is probably going to be a sort of dark and slightly raunchy. Knowing them. So yeah, for a slower song musically, this is pretty solid. It's got everything industrial metal it gives to offer. The heavy downbeat, you know, which is the measure of the start of every, which is the measure at the start of every, the beat at the start of every measure, at the start and at the end. It's always real super heavy. That the downbeat from the start to the end of the beat has to be bump, has to be really hard. It's got everything you'd be looking for. It's a nice little ballad, although I feel like it's not as invocative as songs like Ohne Dich. This does not produce the same kind of emotional response. I don't think it would exactly fade into the background, though. It's definitely attention-grabbing and it's fairly punchy. But it is a tad mild. And I suppose, depending on who you are, that might be a good thing. A little bit milder. So with that being said, musically speaking, I have no serious gripes with this. I would just personally prefer something a little milder. I've been listening to some good shit lately, so you haven't seen my maximum snobbery as of yet. Oh, but trust me, if you send me some eventually, you'll see some snobbery. I have high standards when it comes to music. That's why I got that name. My ex used to call me a song snob. But suffice to say, musically speaking, this was a very mild 5 out of 5. This is a very mild 5 out of 5. And I do have a English translation available. My German's not very good yet. But I like German stuff. So I like to learn the language. Ich spreche Deutsch. Anyway. So, lyrical breakdown says, I can do without fortune because it carries misfortune in itself. Wow. That's deep. I need to destroy it. What I love, I want to adjust. I'm glad must not be no. Well, I think a lot of people can do with that fortune, depending on your definition of fortune. The idea of fortune carrying misfortune within itself? Are you talking about materialism? I feel like this is talking about materialism. Well, there's a few misfortunes added to misfortune. Wasted time, wasted youth, wasted money, destruction, disease, you ruin your life sometimes. I suppose this could be about materialism or excess attachment. Maybe this is sort of Buddhist almost in a way. You know, so attachment being the source of suffering. I need to destroy it. What I love, I want to adjust. You need to destroy what you love? Ugh. See, I knew they were going to go this way. They always go this way. Rammstein is always unpleasant lyrically, but also very meaningful at the same time. They do that to you. He wants to adjust. You want to adjust to what? You want to adjust to the absence of what you love? Well, it's a good survival skill at least. I don't know if that's necessarily the best for your mental well-being. That I'm glad must not be. You mustn't be glad? I wonder why he wants suffering so bad. I don't love that I love something. I don't like it if I like something. I'm not delighted when I'm delighted, yet I know I will regret it. So this is speaking to a kind of personal duality. this might have to do with attachment or even addiction. You're like, you're addicted to something. You know, you, quote, love something. So I don't think that they're speaking on actual love, more in the colloquial sense, or genuine like, which is a also in the more in the less in the colloquial proper and more in the colloquial sense. I think this speaks to addiction and wanting there to be an absence of a thing that's dragging you down, but you're hooked on it, so you keep doing it anyway. I think that's what it is. I think this might be speaking to the idea of alcohol or caffeine or gaming or just any bad habit. Gambling. And in the end, maybe you will regret the absence of that thing. You'll regret the suffering that results from it, but it's something you got to go through. You can't go through life avoiding all suffering. It's basically impossible, not unless you completely withdraw from the world and become insulated. But that makes you weak. It drains your strength and makes you impotent, which is not good. That I'm glad must not be. Who loves it? Who loves me shrinks thereby. So it mustn't be that you're glad. And whoever loves you is thereby shrunk by ever loving you. Because what you love is dragging you down, and now you're dragging everyone else down. This sounds more and more like an addiction. What I love, that will spoil. What I love, that will die. Oh, die. Well, a lot of things die. Death is really more of a transition than an end. It is a changing of states. It is a changing of relationships. And sometimes things do have to die, and things have to spoil. So, we're clearly not talking about a real love here. We're talking about something that's perishable and something that's temporary. So this is love. So I hold myself harmless, I'm not allowed to love, then I do not need to suffer, no, and no heart breaks. So yeah, this almost sounds kind of Buddhist. I actually know a guy, I haven't spoken to him in a while, who's from Austria. And apparently there is a kind of appeal in the Germanic part of the world to ideas similar to Buddhism, that attachment is the source of suffering, and being unattached and efficient in your suffering and the bearing of your cross, so to speak, is desirable. So this may be simply a very Germanic sort of attitude, but they could also have ties to that self-nihilistic spiritual path. Possibly. That is not to say that I think that Rammstein is going to start covering their album covers and like Buddhist imagery or anything, but I think it definitely appeals to the culture of that part of the world for sure. So one simple chorus repeat followed by one final verse. Happiness and joy are followed by torment for everything beautiful one has to pay. Yes. Well, most everything carries with it a price. You have to make a sacrifice in order to get something, right? If you want to get the mighty oak, you have to give up the acorn. You have to sacrifice for something greater to come out of it. And happiness and joy being followed by torment. Well, yeah, you learn to love someone, and then that person leaves your life and dies. Well, that's the torment that follows. Most everything is pain and pleasure. It's never just pain or never just pleasure. It's always a little of both. Even war is pain and pleasure. The pain is the war itself, but the pleasure is the spoils. That's just kind of how life is. Everything has an almost dualistic polarity of pain and suffering and joy and pleasure. And it's tapping into that as well. So this is very meaningful. And it has a very poetic flow. People might think that German, even in translated to English, is not a musical language. Let's just agree to disagree. There is a definite flow. And honestly, German is such a descriptive language. You can literally create a giant word, actually, where you just throw in a bunch of descriptors into a giant phrase, and it's actually considered all one word. Right, it can get super descriptive. Also, be careful if you want to dive deep into, like, German translations of English songs. Be careful. sometimes the German versions get really grotesque. Like Hellfire and Hunchback of Notre Dame. Be careful with the German version. It's yeah. Be careful with the level of descriptiveness here. I think Rammstein kept it fairly tame in comparison to how descriptive they can get. They could have gotten much, much worse. The poetic flow is nice. The English translation is good. And all in all, I would say that lyrically, this is a very meaningful song, but it's going to require some time to fully appreciate its meaning. With that being said, it is a little vague. It's a bit vague. But it is not juvenile, childish in any capacity, that's for damn sure. Because of the vagueness of it, I think that's generally they're trying to get the audience to kind of grow with the meaning of the song. But clarity in music is kind of a must. One of my criteria is that lyrics cannot be overly vague. That's why I often have to take points away from, like, Prague. I might not have mentioned it in my trailer. I'm pretty sure I did. So this is actually a 4 out of 5 for being a bit too vague. But otherwise, very excellent and definitely something you should spend time to meditate on the meaning of. You know, what attachments or loves in your life are toxic and maybe you should withdraw from, maybe if only temporarily. That's something to think about. I certainly have a few things that I'm a little too hooked on. Gaming, caffeine, maybe obsessing over some junky thoughts that I shouldn't be obsessing over because they're really just dragging me down. But it can be very hard to let go of those kinds of things. It's a challenge in and of itself. With that being said, there will be a link in the description below to my books. Please buy, download, and read them. And as always, tschüss, peace. Tschüss is German for goodbye.